Oh, hello. Welcome back to the Double M Farm. This, I guess we'll call part one of the next year-long process of digging out our spring-fed farm pond here on the Double M Farm. What you're looking at is the head of one of the two springs that's coming down from the front of the property. I am over on the new side. I'm trying to shade the sun off the camera. I am over across the fence on the new side, the part I'm buying. My fence is right there. And you can see the green grass on the other side in the pasture. And then you'll probably be able to see the hill as it goes up towards the barn. Well, right there is a cavity. And water is just pouring out from under the ground coming here. And running right there and going on down towards the creek in the back of the property. That's that one. And then if we just move over about 8 or 10 feet, there's the second spring that runs down from the through the ditch that runs parallel to my existing fence that will soon be gone. And that spring is coming down and joining with that spring and running on down. And as I pan back over across the fence on my existing property, it goes up. And if I pan around 180 degrees, it goes up that way. And I don't know if they're showing up on camera, but there's some orange flagging right in the center of the screen, right there up on the hill. That's my new property line. And I'm walking on dry land here. Excuse me, I'm working my way through, but I'm walking dry land because the spring is over there in the existing little ditch that will be dug out into a pond. And it's not going to be a problem keeping water in this pond. I've just showed you two springs. And then look here, here's dry land. And right here, look at that. Another spring just bubbling up out of the ground right there. And the water is coming from that and running down through there. And I mean running, just bubbling up out of the ground. So that makes three different places. And I know if you go underground, this is all probably part of one big aquifer under the ground. But basically it's three different spring heads coming up out of the ground in three different places right here in what will be the head of the pond. And as I move my fence over, I'll get the goats in here and let them clean as much of this as they will. Then I'll start cutting and digging with the Harbor Freight trencher. And as you can see, it's not a lot of big stuff to cut. The pond will go, and there's an orange flag right there up on the hill. That's the new property line, and hopefully I know slopes don't show up on camera, but it goes up pretty rapidly right there. So my property line will be right on the rise as it goes up. There's a big orange flag on that pine tree right there. That's the property line, the new property line. That's where my fence will be. And like I say, you can see there's not a lot of big stuff in here. It's just a bunch of little stuff. And I'll be cutting it out. And then I will start right back there where we started this video. I apologize for the sun. Where we started this video, that's where I'll start digging out. I will basically just dig a wide ditch starting over on my existing property and coming over this way. There goes the shovel. And just go back and forth digging, working my way towards the camera and making the hole bigger and bigger. And as deep as possible. And basically I won't be building a dam because this is a low bowl. I'm just standing in the middle of a bowl that springs are bubbling up in. So if I just dig down, the water obviously is going to collect in the bowl. And then I can get the water to go further up the hill by damming, if I so choose, back there at the creek. But just wanted to give you a quick update. We'll call it part one of what is going to be a long process. Here you see more of that water coming out of that third spring. And it is moving water. May not show up on camera. Yeah, I believe you can see it there how it's moving. That's just bubbling up out of the flat ground. The other two springs are over there, running that way. And this water eventually curves and gets over into that same ditch with the other two springs. So all I got to do is just dig a bowl here and let the water collect. And I'm going to have about a 3/4 acre pond. It's going to be really neat. We're looking forward to it. So that's what we'll be doing over the course of the next probably 6 months to a year. This is December, so it's perfect time to get in here while it's thin and all the leaves are down. And we'll call this part one. And I'm not sure when I'll do part two. I'll probably not do part two until I get the fence moved over. And unless something happens between now and then that's worthy of an update, I'm not going to bore you with a lot of these kind of videos. Just wanted to give you an idea of what the property looks like and what the springs look like. And we got a lot of water here. So if we dig us out a bowl, we're going to have a whole lot of water collecting here. And it's going to be pretty easy to control. I'll do a video later back there at the back end where it's going to actually stop before it gets to the creek and show you how that's going to work. But it's going to be fun. It's going to be a lot of work for a 67-year-old man. But if I die out here, I'll die happy. And my son and grandkids will have a mess to finish. But they'll have a pond to play in and fish in when I'm long gone. So what the heck, I'm retired. I got to have something to do, right? I don't want COVID to kill me, so I'd rather die out here digging a pond. That's what we're going to do. Maybe I won't catch COVID out here in the woods with the goats. I got deer walking through here. I got bear walking through here. I got coyote walking through here. So when my time comes and the good Lord's ready for me, maybe one of those will take me instead of that stupid COVID that everybody's talking about. So good luck to all of you. I hope you're staying safe. And I'll post another video update as soon as there's something to talk about other than just water bubbling out of the ground. So we are well on our way to getting this thing started. And I welcome you to come along and join us for the ride. Hopefully it'll be interesting and entertaining. So thank you for visiting us here in the swamp on the Double M Farm. And we'll talk to you again real soon.